Hey guys, welcome to another video. The Samsung Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus, output on April 28th, so it's been almost 7 months, priced at $720 for the S8 and $820 for the S8 Plus. For S9 we should logically expect to see them arrive in April the same, but some rumors suggest that it could happen in January, because the production would indeed already started or would start in December. But why would it happen soon? Probably to answer the release of the iPhone X, but good, after that are rumors we'll see, which is almost certain it will be this year a normal model and a model more like the year before. It also seems likely that the screen size remains the same with a few changes, which I'll talk about later. So a S9 of 5.8 inches and a S9 Plus more than 6.2 inches. However, some rumors evoke the arrival of a S9 Mini, a mini high-end smartphones. What size? Mystery. It is true that today high-end smartphones are getting bigger, which pushes the fans of small smartphones to turn either towards the middle of range, or towards a smartphone too big for them. So why not a 9-inch mini or a little less? It would be an interesting strategy. It is true that we cannot find many small high-end smartphones on the side of Android. On the design side, now again according to some rumors and even potential leak, the Galaxy S9 design would not change enormously. Those who do not like smartphones notch can reassure themselves, even if some Android smartphones start to get started, Galaxy S9 no probably will not adopt. So we go on the screen a little lower, aboard at least bottom with its rounded edges. It would have a slight black stripes at the bottom, and a thicker at the top, which it would contain the various sensors and cameras. On the back of the camera would be a double photo sensor recently introduced by the Galaxy Note 8, is still a fingerprint scanner, per so again I find it not very well placed. This fingerprint scanner to the behind it is still very very close to the objective's photo. If these leaks are found, hello fingerprints. After all, I'm not particularly fond of the impression sensor placed on the back of the camera. Luckily the Galaxy will certainly still offer an unlocking alternative with its front sensors. Again according to rumors we would lose this time the headphone jack. I think we are really burying this jack in a year or two, by the way. In my opinion it will be very difficult to find high-end smartphones with the headphone jack. Now about its likely features. I've already talked about the 5.8 inch screen for the S9 and 6.2 inch for the S9 Plus, with a query for a possible mini model. On the front side at the top of the device we would find new third sensors to offer a kind of competitors of the face it of the iPhone X, while maintaining the iris sensor already present on the Samsung Galaxy S8, but that's not all. We would have the right this time a dual photo sensor on the front of 12 megapixels. Why a dual photo sensor on the front? Can be a normal on a very wide angle for selfie in very wide angle for example. Why not after I do not know. In the back we will also find a double 16 megapixel photo sensor apparently again according to rumors, with probably a wide angle and a telephoto lens. Note that it would have the ability to shoot slow motion in 1000 fps. I also think that this dual photo sensor will be available on all models of Samsung Galaxy S9, the S9, the S9 Plus, and maybe the S9 Mini, who knows. Rumors also suggest that Samsung will always work on the integration of the fingerprint scanner under the screen, and they would find themselves in the back in case of failure. If the leaked photos are real, it looks like they have not succeeded. Personally, I find that if they develop a battery, two facial sensors, they should rather abandon the fingerprint scanner. After that remains a personal opinion. About the possible price now for these different Galaxy S9, I think already finally it's almost certain that we will not go below prices of S8 and S8 Plus, namely as I told you from $720 for S8 and $820 for the S8 Plus. I think even besides that they will increase. It's unfortunately a big trend at the moment. The high-end have become very high-end a point at least, the mid-ranges have become top of the range, and the low-cost have become medium-sized ranges, leaving room for new low-cost products. Now we end up with four ranges: low cost, middle range, high end, and very high end. Upscale it left room as I said for the low cost. We can see that Nokia and other low-end manufacturers have entered the breach. I cannot wait to see what the other brands are going to present at the Mobile World Congress 2018. In my opinion, this vintage 2018 would be very interesting. In short, so how much breaks? In my opinion, the price of S9 will start at $799 and the S9 plus $899. I think that this rise in price may justify the arrival of a S9 Mini. And if it exists, it could very well be marketed from $599 for a 5-inch screen. Anyway, I'll let you know, and I cannot wait to see it. Here is, tell me what you think in the comments of this video. And if you are interested, tell me what you would like to see on this Galaxy S9. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video. Take care and peace out.